Hey guys, in this video we're going to cover the mixing tools and signal routing in SoundBridge. We'll go over how to group tracks, create a send, and all the controls such as panning and volume that are available for each track from the mixer view. Before starting this video, make sure you've checked out the previous videos in the series so you're all caught up. To get started with mixing, the first thing we can do is switch to the mixer view. This displays all our tracks vertically, and it's easier to make edits at this point in our project. At the top, we have signal routing that includes the inputs and outputs. Like we saw before, our inputs can be microphones or MIDI devices, depending on what kind of track we're using. The default audio output for every track is just the master channel. When working with a MIDI track, we'll also have a MIDI output we can use if we want to send the MIDI signal to another device. In most cases, I'll skip this step since I process all my MIDI within the program. Now let's cover how to add a send. To add a send, first we need to switch back to the tracks view. Then add a new track and change the track type to return. We'll call this track reverb. The return track will be created at the bottom. Switch back to the mixer view and the reverb track can be found on the right. At the top of the track, we have the track output, which we'll keep set as master track in. We'll also leave it pre-mixer so that changes to the level of the individual tracks won't affect the send. Now that we've added the send, the other tracks will automatically route to it. On those tracks, we can increase the level of the send using the slider to create a mix between the instruments sent to it. If we create more than one send, there will be multiple sliders to control the levels sent to them. Like the other tracks, the send has panning, solo, mute, write automation, and a volume slider. The sends also have the option to use sends, but be careful not to create a loop. A typical scenario where you'd want to use a send is with a reverb. Multiple instruments can be sent to the same reverb processor, and the reverb is applied to all the tracks together. This helps glue the mix together a little better when compared to just applying individual reverb to all the tracks. Another way we can combine tracks is by grouping them. To get this started, we need to switch back to the track view by clicking the button at the bottom. Then hold down the shift button on the keyboard and click on the tracks you want in the group to select them. You can also do this by pressing the shift button on the bottom panel if you're working on a touchscreen. You can tell what tracks are part of the group because the color indicator for them is the same. I also like to change the group name when I create it. To do this, right-click on the group name and a window will open up. Then you can click on the name and change it. The other thing we can do is change the group color indicator. If we want to get rid of the group after, just select the group and press the ungroup button at the top. In some other programs, we would create a group by changing the output of a few tracks to a bus, but that's not how it works in SoundBridge. Once our group is created, we can switch back to the mixer view. We now have the controls like we would have for an individual track that is applied to the entire group at once. Starting at the top, we have the audio output which goes to the master channel. Then we have a send which will send the entire group to another track. Every audio track, MIDI track, group, and return has more controls at the bottom. The first knob at the top of this section is the pan control. If we drag it down, the track pans left, and if we drag it up, it pans right. If we double-click the knob, it will recenter. Below that, we have the solo button. When we solo a track, it will be the only track playing. If there are multiple solo tracks, they will all play as well, but the unsoloed tracks will not. Then we have a mute button, which stops the track from playing. On a group, MIDI track, return, and master, we have an arm automation button, and we'll cover automation in a future video. Audio tracks have an input monitor button that processes the microphone input with the plugins and plays it back in real time. To the right, we have a slider we can drag up or down to change the level. This is called the fader. The slider can range from +8 to minus infinity. Double-clicking on the slider will cause it to reset to zero. In the bottom left, we have two level indicators. The top is the peak level indicator, which displays the peak volume since it started. We can click on this to reset it. Below we have an indicator for the level of the fader. Thanks for checking out this video on the mixer and signal routing in SoundBridge. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to give it a like, subscribe to the channel, and press the bell icon to get notifications whenever a new video is released. You can also check the video description for links to social media accounts so you can stay up to date on all our new content.